We love you and we're cheering for you. Say love you, Daddy.
Oh, man.
That's it. We love you.
Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, for the Bible tells me so. I listen to your mother sing this song to you every night. And the craziest part is, you ain't gonna remember any of this. All these moments we share will simply slip into the forgotten pages of the past for you, but only for you, because I will never forget. Never forget all the things that you made me feel, how I was already in love with you before I could ever hold you as your mother cradled you into existence. I prayed for you the best way I knew how, by praying for me, praying my inadequacies not become a family legacy, that these sins I carry me to cemetery before they ever become hereditary, because you scare me. Because I don't want to plant grotesque seeds. You'll one day have to come back to weed. What I'm saying is, I never want you to be forced to pluck painful memories of me out of your psyche. I want our time spent to be God-sent, so when you look back on these days, you remember how sweet the smell is. I'll never forget the day you came into this world, the hell you caused your mother. Well, technically, it was my fault you were there in the first place, but that's a biology lesson for a whole nother day. Anyway. I'll never forget holding you in my arms for the very first time. How your presence compelled time to stand still because it knew in that moment nothing else mattered. How with you in my grasp, I understood what it meant to wear your heart on your sleeve. Just you in the eye, staring eye to eye, and in yours, I could see the love we shared and the safety you felt. I wonder, could you see the fear that lied behind mine, the way Daddy's life was forever changed by the gift of your presence? Because the moment you entered the picture, it drew out all of my selfishness, illustrated how far I still have to go to do what I've been called to do, to move where I've been called to move. But, boo-boo, there's no more time left for fear. Only time left to build more memories, longer legacies. Aaliyah, in you, I will plant the best of me. My love, my passion, my drive, my hope, it all lies in you because, boo-boo, what you've yet to realize is so many nights as a child, I would pray for the earth in hopes that I could change it. And baby girl, you have become my world. And I know that if I can change your life for the better, that God must be real due to that answered prayer. So Aaliyah, my beautiful daughter, be you. And whatever that entails, let passion be your motor, let wisdom be your guide, and your mother and I will be your biggest cheerleaders on the scene, no matter victory or defeat. Because boo-boo, this life will knock you on your behind more times than you can count, but you must get up queen, you must stand up queen, wear your crown queen, because you are so much stronger than what you think. All those nights in which these lips press prayers through them for the sake of your now and soon to come, boo-boo. You got heaven standing behind you, so who in hell can stand against you, Aaliyah? I promise to give you a childhood of splendid recollections and Daddy's best protection, a prayer. Dear God, I know that you cared for my daughter before she was ever in her mother's womb, and I just pray that your largest of blessings wait in her storehouse of destiny. Because I know ain't none of us perfect, but my daughter, she's worth it. Amen.
He leaves me, you leave me speechless. You really do. I've never experienced anything like this in my life, and especially on this show. Number one, I've never really experienced poetry. You move people, you move the world, you move us more than anybody does. We get to know you like nobody else. When I think of what you've done, you took us on a journey. We met you and we found out you had a terrible loss at the beginning of your life and how you dealt with that. We found out what it was like to be a black man today and what through the eyes of your mother. And then we found out, you know, now what it's like to be a father. You take us on these journeys, you know, or how to deal with a single parent. You're amazing. I know in 2017 you tried out for the show. We said no, I'm glad we said no, because now, more than ever, you are more important and better than you will ever be. Right. I love you, buddy.
Thank you. Thank you. My God.
Sophia.
Like Howie said, this is a new experience for me, and I have loved it. I have gone, you know, from the beginning to the end, enjoying every time that you are here on this stage. It's so meaningful. I think this was one of my favorite performances that you have done, because it was very hopeful. It was to your baby. It was, and I liked also that you were, for the first time, were outside of the stage. That you were like in that feeling of the streets. Why are you looking at me like that?
We're out of time.
Oh, we're out of time. Sorry. You're great.
Heidi.
I mean, what a beautiful gift to your daughter, and what a beautiful gift to all of us you are, you know? I truly believe that you deserve a show in Las Vegas, and we as people, we deserve more artists like you, artists that speak the truth, artists that are humble, because that really hits home, and that is power. And I want to thank you for being here.
Thank you so much.